Well, one issue about records is, I mean, I guess that's an issue that has become bigger and bigger since Common Core came along.
Right.
What's going on in Nevada?
So if you were a parent in Nevada and you wanted to see the records the school was compiling on your kids, that would be a reasonable request, right?
I would think seeing your own kids' records, yes.
What about for the price of $10,000?
Yeah, I mean, I would think someone ought to undercut
that. Slightly less reasonable. Well, that's what's going on here.
Okay.
A Nevada parent wanted the State Department of Education to share the information it's collecting on his kids. Though he wasn't technically turned down, he was informed that it would cost him over $10,000 to access. The department's public information officer, Judy Osgood, rationalized this by saying, "Please understand that the primary purpose of the Department of Education's database is to support required state and federal reporting, funding for local education agencies, education accountability, and public reporting. The system currently is not capable of responding to the type of individual student data request you have presented." Naturally, this has risen some concern, not only that the student's privacy is being invaded, but also that the state's $10 million student database might be violating federal law, namely the Family Educational Rights and Privacy Act, which allows parents to review their child's school records. Kalia Barnes is the director of the Student Privacy Project at EPIC, the Electronic Privacy Information Center in Washington, D.C. She expressed some of her concerns to Choice Media.
It's completely outrageous because it completely violates the federal student privacy law. The Family Educational Rights and Privacy Act, or FERPA, guarantees students and their parents the right to access education records. It also states that when you look in the federal regulations, educational agencies and institutions are forbidden from charging students to access their records.
As I see it, the interesting thing is that it's, what is this data normally for? In other words, if it allegedly takes them $10,000 to dig out any student piece of information, mm-hmm. piece of student information, why are they gathering it at all? Like, if it's that hard to find, if it's that hard to get to make use of this database, what is the point of it?
And how could it possibly cost $10,000 to access?
Right, it's like months and months of it. Yeah. Engineers, computer scientists going through this. I don't know.
For one guy's couple children.
Right. So, Priya, what do you think?
Oh, that just sounds ridiculous to me. I don't know how. Again, I'm similar to you. I'm just gobsmacked that it would cost that much to access your own kids' data records. Like you said, what is it there for? We have these government transparency websites and data collection systems to serve the public and to serve taxpayers, not to create a bureaucracy that provides continuous and repeated denials to people who ask for information.
I know. There's not much to say. It's just obviously just bureaucrats run amok. What is that word you use to describe your shock and awe at the situation?
Gobsmacked.
Wow. Well, I'm gobsmacked, too. I didn't even know I was, but I'm even more convinced that I am. So, you have any other thoughts on this?
No, I'm pretty gobsmacked myself.
All right. That's 3 for 3.